kind of participating by himself or with some other guys that didn't appear to be first teamers. Not the regular first teamers. Is there any concern that he is not going to participate in training camp related to his contract situation?
No, we can modify. So Franco, for example, played two games of training today. So we try to really modify the players who need it. He's one of them. He's just the first in training. Everyone who's on the pitch here today,
Frank, we talked to you in November and you mentioned how important it would be to get the squad as fully formed as possible, as early as possible, to have success early in the season. How are you feeling about the squad right now?
Every year I want that, and it's not always happening, but you know, it's not only that I want it, but of course the club wants it also. It's also some strategic moves you have to do, of course, you know, not pay the highest price and everything, and you have to wait sometimes. So I know how it goes in this world of soccer, but as a coach you want it as fast as possible. You also know that the reality is that it's not like that. At the end, somebody can come to strengthen your roster, but also can leave your roster, and we have to accept it. It's not nice again, but I will not panic, that's for sure.
How much input have you had on the signings that the club has made, and why is the club loaning Carleton?
Well, he didn't play Carleton because of Carleton. He didn't play that much last season. And we think in a new environment, it's good for him, so that's why the reason we chose to hire him for loaning. Then the transfers, of course, you know, I have very close contact with the Carleton manager, technical director. He did already a great job, you know, when they started here. So we have close, he knows what I want. Yeah, he's the guy, you know, who pushes the button if he comes or not.
Well, and that goes both ways. Did you have any say in Leandro's selling to Tijuana?
No. I know that Leandro, you know, wants to also, you know, have a new environment. So I think after 3 years, you know, sometimes it's good for players, you know, to move along, to get that sparkling, you know, the new energy. So it's also both sides, you know, to have new players, new energy in the locker room. You know, every 3 years you have to have that. So I also said that to Carlos that I want also some new players, and you have to have new energy. Of course, Negri is gone, Leandro is gone. Are very good players. They contribute fantastic for Atlanta United. But, you know, other players have to stand up now. They were very important for Atlanta United. But now other players are going to bring other energy, and I think that's good.
Carlos said last week on the teleconference that left back and central midfield were two positions he was looking to strengthen. Are there any other positions that you would like for the club to try to find some players?
Well, now for me, he knows exactly what I want. So for me, especially the loss of Negri, we have to have a good replacement. Of course, we will not get him back at that quality, but another player can have different qualities than Negri. They will fill up that gap, so hopefully we're going to see a midfielder. That's for me the most important. Of course, the left fullback, if you see George Pello didn't play last season, only 2.5 games or 1 game. And so it's very important that we don't put all our money on George, that he's going to play all season left fullback. So we have to modify him also. And, you know, if we can, hopefully he's doing well and performing well, and he can play like 15 to 20 games, should be great. So we need also that position to cover.
We had a long off season to think about the roster. Joseph, Pitti, Marco, and Tito. Have you kind of figured out a way to get all four of those guys on the field at the same time?
Yeah,
they put himself in. I always put a team in who I think is the best team to win against the next opponent. And if it's with those four, I'm going to play with those four. So it's not up to me, it's up to them.
So you have to fill out the sheet.
Yes, we're going to train it and I will practice it, that's for sure. And if it goes well, you know, in our friendly game, and we have success, then well, I'm the first one, you know, to get those names on the form. So for me, it's no problem. But we have to see, you know, what the best is. You know, Julian Gressel is also very important. So, and then he's doing well. So yeah, I can only put 11. And for me, I always put what in my point of view the best team we can have in 3 points.
I guess I'm wondering if Tito is, might work out in a position or something to try to get him on.
No, yeah, you know, Tito for me is a winger or you know, really a striker in a 4-4-2 system. He's not really, he played sometimes like a wing back, but it was more to force something, you know, we were maybe 1-0 down or something like that. But in the three system, when we play the three in the back, for him it's more difficult because then normally you have Johnson, Barco and Pitti. But we also played the last couple of games 4-3-3. I think that's a good opportunity for him, you know, if he's doing well at training. Today was fantastic. Again, you know, you put yourself in the team.
Frank, what do you hope to see out of this team in the next month or so before your Champions League debut?
Well, you know, I think LeBron James said it once, the off-season is my real season. I want to see that from our guys. We had three normal trainings during the whole season last season. So that means that this is a period that we have to get to our strength and hopefully our top level. So that's for me the most important. And technically, I think I want to see that we can really swap from three in the back to four in the back and recognize those moments when to press or not to press. So, but I'm confident that that we. Don't start from scratch, but what I saw him also against the last game, we did well also before that, so I'm confident that we can go more in smaller details to be even better.
Can you talk about him and his qualities like that?
Well, he's like a typical Parkinson, very aggressive like Leandro, so he likes to also take some risks sometimes with the ball. I had the same. And of course, you have to balance it always, you know, how much risk you can take. But I love his attitude. He's also a leader. We wanted to have a leader in that position because Leandro is one, of course. So, and he is. He wants to be a coach when he starts his career. So then you have to be, you know, understanding what the trainer expects. From his players, but I need a leader, especially, okay, Miles is not still a leader, you know, he's still young. If you have George maybe on that side, yeah, he has two youngsters on his side, so it's for me very important that you have a leader, and I think he is.
I just want to know if you've been scouting the title already.
What?
Have you begun scouting your champ title on the title?
Yeah, just a few hours ago, I saw the first game. It was not that clear, you know, to see the whole, what kind of system, but they won 0-3, so, and you know, you have to be fully prepared, you know, to win this kind of game. I remember, I think it was against the Panama team in Toronto, and it lost like 4-0, it could be 10-0, I think, that game, so, if you think you're going to underestimate them, we're going to have a very hard time, so we have to be ready on the 8th.
I just wanted to clarify, what was the reason that Gressel was off by himself today? Do you anticipate that going forward?
No, because he wasn't ready for the 11 against 11, because the others were already earlier here, training, you know, it was, you know, on voluntary days, and so we wanted to see, hey, where is this level, and so we will integrate to tomorrow.
As a coach, what is the difference between being here for the first year and now the second year?
Well, you know, we understand, you know, a little bit the teams feeling what they want, what they expect. Players the same from us, and again, you know, we don't start from scratch. We know already like 80%, 85% what we want. They understand that. Now we have to try to modify it and try to get those small details better, and then we can make big steps. And hopefully, you know, we will then less get this season.
What have you learned? What have you learned about living in Atlanta, living in the state of Georgia first?
Well, it was a very tough season and a long season, so I was almost only in Atlanta. Couldn't explore Georgia a bit much, but I love it here. You know, and, it's a great city, it's a great apartment. And people are very nice. And, yeah, everything is good in this environment to work on the top level.
When
just
will
a couple more,
when will the captain?
What?
When will the next team captain be there?
Well, normally is that from the first game. This is that. Maybe also from friendly games you will see. I don't know yet, but I have already in my mind the first two are, and the third and fourth are still figured out because Leandro and Parkhurst are gone, of course, so we have to fill up those gaps and still figuring out what's the best, how the best way to do.
When you said the 1, 2, 3, 4, you referred to the preseason games?
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't know if you were there with the length of the players, so to speak.
No, but I need, normally we have four captains, like 1, 2, 3, 4.
Uh-huh.
Right now I have two, not in which particular order, but I think everybody knows that Jeff and Brad Husen are normally our captains. Yeah. And the other two, we have to
Frank, do you want to say, you might have a couple players from Miles and Miles and Largo potentially going to be in the team this summer. Obviously, that's a big opportunity for those players. You anticipate it called a lot of that team that happens.
We have to see, and I don't know. They have to go, or, you know, with conversation that thinks it's better that he stays, but also another player is very important. Maybe he thinks, yeah, Atlantic my priority, or yeah, I want to, yeah, go to the league, but we have to see how that goes. But it's a concern, of course, for us.
Anything else?